Earth, billions of years ago, it was just a hot jumble of elements which over time have solidified into the very rocks that we stand on. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. These rocks have come from a quarry in Portland, and they're made of limestone, which is a type of calcium carbonate. Masons would use these blocks pretty much as they are in the construction industry. These rocks have been formed over millions of years from shells like this. So these have just collected at the bottom of the ocean and been compressed, and we can actually even see some of the shells in this rock here. Because the shell and the rock are made of the same chemical substance, calcium carbonate, they have the same chemical properties. So here we have some hydrochloric acid, and the bubbles that you see instantly formed in here, this is carbon dioxide gas. There's another way we can drive out the carbon dioxide, and that's simply by heating it. So this block now has been in the oven for 24 hours. It was allowed to cool overnight. And, well, it looks pretty much just the same as it did before, but actually it's completely different. Its chemical structure has now changed. Before we had calcium carbonate, and heating it up drives out the carbon dioxide and leaves us with calcium oxide, or quicklime. Because we've driven out all of the carbon dioxide from this rock, it's actually lost quite a lot of its weight. But it's also changed in structure, and we're now going to see why it is that you won't find any buildings made out of calcium oxide. The change that takes place when limestone is converted into quicklime, or calcium oxide, has been known for many hundreds of years. Here in this book from 1526, we see the process. We see a chap with a furnace in the background and boulders of limestone, and he's pouring water on this. Quicklime literally means living lime, and we can see this as the water instantly vaporizes. It's turning into steam in this very violent reaction. It's combining with the quicklime. We can see it crumbling away, blistering. Bits of it are flying off, popping in all directions, generating a lot of heat, which we can see as the steam here. During this process called slaking, the calcium oxide reacts with the water to form calcium hydroxide. And this is a key component of cement. This has been used since Roman times, and it's still used today.